Hey, what's up YouTubers, Tanmay here for Simple Snippets with a new video tutorial series on operational research. So operational research is a domain in IT which deals with how to assign or optimize your business processes by using mathematical calculations and some different techniques. So in this video tutorial, we'll be seeing the assignment problem and the method is going to be Hungarian method. So let's start with the problem. So here's the question. Solve the following assignment problem and find the optimum assignment that will result in minimum man hours needed. So as you can see, I have a 2D matrix here and the rows consist of workers. So this is the worker 1, or you can see the first column wherein we have 5 different workers with numbers. So this is the first worker, this is the second one, and we have 5 different jobs which you can see in this row. And these values are the time required for worker 1 to perform job 1. Similarly, the time required for worker 1 to complete job 2 is given as 9 hours. So these are in hours. So what we have to do is we have to find out optimum solution. That means that we have to find out the minimum number of hours all of these workers can complete these jobs. So each worker can do one job. And it has to be one unique job, and all the jobs need to be completed by all the individual workers, and we have to find out the least amount of time in which they can do it. So basically our aim is to assign exactly one job to each person so that the total time required to complete all the jobs is minimum. So that's what we are going to do in this problem. So let's see the steps involved in this problem. Okay, so as you can see on the screen, we have a 2D matrix with again the 4 different jobs and 4 different workers and the time required. So the steps are, first we have to select the minimum element of a row and subtract it from each element of that same row. Then second thing we have to do is select minimum element of a column and subtract it from each element of that particular column. Then we have to draw minimum number of lines covering all the rows which has 0. So if the line drawn is equal to n, that is equal to number of workers or number of jobs, then the solution is optimal. And then we have to just assign the values which consist of 0. So I'll show you what exactly it means. Else we need to select the minimum number of uncovered elements and subtract it from each of the uncovered elements and add it to the intersection of two lines. So the last two points might be a bit confusing, but you'll understand when you solve the numerical. So let's go ahead and solve the numerical first. Okay, so as I said, the step 1, we need to select minimum element of a row and subtract it from each element of that row. So let's say the first row. Now here the minimum element is 2. So we'll subtract 2 from each of these values. So 3 minus 2, I'll write it down over here, it's 1. Then 9 minus 2 is 7. 2 minus 2 is 0. 3 minus 2 is 1. And 7 minus 2 is 5. Similarly, I'll calculate the values for all the rows and let me just write it down. You can also quickly calculate in a rough paper. And for the last row, I'll just repeat the step again. We have to take the minimum from the last row, that is 2, and subtract it from each of the values of the same row. So 9 minus 2, that would give us 7, 6 minus 2, 4, 2 minus 2, 0. And 4 minus 2 would be 2, 5 minus 2 would be 3. So you have to repeat this for all these rows. And so this is the answer for step 1. So that this is what we get after we perform the step 1. Now for the step 2, we have to select the minimum of a column and subtract it from each element of that column. And we have to perform this on the new matrix that we have found. So we have to perform the operation on this matrix. So in step 2, we have to take the column. So let's start with the first column. In this column, we know the minimum value is 1. So let's subtract 1 from each of these. So 1 minus 1 would give us 0. Then 5 minus 1 would give us 4. 6 minus 1 would give us 5. Again, 1 minus 1 would give us 0. And 7 minus 1 would give us 6. For the next column, we know the minimum is 0. So if we subtract 0 from each of these elements in this same column, we'll get the same answer. So we'll keep it as it is. For this column, we have minimum as 0, and subtracting 0 from each of these values of this same column would again give us the same values. For the fourth column, we have again value of 1, which is minimum. So we'll subtract 1 from each of these elements. So 1 minus 1 would be 0, 5 minus 1 would be 4, 7 minus 1 would be 6, 0 and 1. And the fifth column would be remain as it is, as the minimum value is 0, and when we subtract 0 from each of these values, we'll get the same result. So now the step 2 is done. Now after performing step 2, the step 3 is we have to draw minimum number of lines covering all the rows or columns having zeros. So let's just first mark where all the zeros are. So this is 1, 0. We have another 0 over here. This is one more. Okay, so now what we have to do is we have to use the minimum number of lines to mark all the zeros. So here's what I can do. To cover these 3 zeros, I can use one line. Then to cover these 3 zeros, I can use one single line. Now I'm still left with this 0, this 0 and this 0. So I need to use 3 lines. So I can use them vertically or horizontally. Right now I'm using them horizontally. Okay, so what I did is I covered all the zeros using the minimum number of lines, and the number of lines here is equal to 5. So the next step is we need to check if the number of lines is equal to the number of rows or is equal to the number of columns. So in this case it is true, because the number of lines is 5 and you can see number of rows and columns is also 5. That is, we have 5 jobs or we have 5 workers, which is equal to the number of lines. So this means that the solution is optimum, and the final answer can be found by using the zero assignment. That means wherever there is a zero, that is our optimum solution. So for each row we can select one zero. So if I select zero for this row, I select this zero, so I cannot use this zero or this zero, or I cannot use this zero as well. And for this row I'll select this zero, for this row I'll select this one, for this row I'll select this one, and if I use this, I cannot use this. So I cannot use this one, I cannot use this one, and I cannot use this one, but for this row I can use this zero. So as you can see, I have marked 4 different or 5 different zeros. Now I just have to check the original question. So original question, at this 0th position we have the value of 3. So the answer, final answer, that is the number of R's is equal to this 3 plus, then I have to check at this position what the value was originally. So at this position, that is 2, 2, the original value is 1. So 3 plus 1. Then for this position, I have to check the value. So 3 and 5. So 3 and 5 would give me 3 plus, for this position, I have to check the value, which is 4 and 4. So 4 and 4 would give me 2. Plus for the last row, I have to check the position, 5 and 3. So 5 comma 3 would give me 2. So this would give me the final answer of 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. And this is our final answer. So the optimum answer, or the answer in this case, is 11 hours, which is the minimum number of hours required for each person to perform exactly one job. So in the next video tutorial, we'll see a variation of this method wherein the number of lines is not equal to number of rows. So we'll see what we have to do in that case. Okay, so that's it for this video. I hope you understood the concept of Hungarian method and how to go about this assignment problem. In the next video tutorial, we'll see a different variation, as I said before. And if you like this video, give it a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe. Peace.